Do you still remember that the appearance adjectives that we learned last class about how to describe somebody using the adjectives? And for instance, if you think someone is he's not fat and he has a very good body figure, what would you say? Perfect. He's lean, he's thin, he's fit. And why shouldn't people use fat to describe something? Do you still remember? And Mina, can you tell me what's the opposite adjective of these three words?
Boring, interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Calm. Quiet. Yeah. Perfect. And relaxing.
Busy.
Yeah, busy. And how do I look?
Nervous.
Yeah, perfect. Very nervous. Okay, so ladies, since you have all got your test paper, I realized, I noticed that in part eight, many of you have lots of difficulties and problems in this part. So now please turn to page 89. Please turn to page 89 in your book. We're going to learn some online writing vocabulary, and then we will go back to page 89. And then we will go back to our unit test paper. And now, ladies, do you read blogs online? Do you read blogs online? I know there's a mini blog named Twitter in the US. Do you always read blogs? Or those blogs on Facebook site? Or other things? Ingrid, do you have the habit of reading the blog? Yeah.
If I
like checking those web pages and maybe checking the other people's Facebook sites. Do you like reading blogs?
Yeah, sometimes.
Only if it is interesting,
yeah.
Right? And Grace, do you like browsing the blogs or reading the blogs?
Yeah.
Why do you like to read them? Lots of information, right? Okay, now I want you to discuss something about reading blogs with your partner in a group of two. And please tell your partner, do you read blogs and do you write a blogs? If you have this habit, please describe to your partner of your blog reading or writing. So Mina will be with Ingrid and Ikumi will be with Lee and Grace will be with Michael and Maria. Government politics, they're connected together.
Where do you stay now? Maybe you can talk a little bit about what are the information that you find out from us.
Important things.
Because
I can die.
Some people are so uptight today.
So you read the Japanese who are living in the US. Perfect. To get some information. Do you write blogs?
No, I don't write. Do you write? It's more popular in China.
It's more Instagram.
Do you mean the passages written sent to everyone who has been subscribed to their account? The person from searching slot.
I like more repost blog about culture, country, government,
government, politics,
politician in general. And I like I say that I like more Instagram.
So you prefer Instagram? Why?
Because you can see, for example, you post a picture, You can read information about the picture, and I send, I like, for example, National Geographic, because you can learn more about different countries and cultures and people, etc., animals, a lot of information. And I like to read interesting things, and I like repost to
repost. So, does everybody know what's the meaning of the repost? Means you see something very interesting and useful, and you want other people to know that, so you click the repost button to resend the blogs or the links on your own page to let other people know. And does anybody know what's the meaning of mark? Means you see something very useful or interesting that you want to go back to see it later, but you do not want to repost it on your own site. So you maybe click some button to make some marks on the blocks or the information, and then you can go back to this post. And also, like, I think everybody knows this, right? On WeChat or on Instagram or on Facebook, if you think somebody's post is really interesting and fantastic, you can click this heart to show that you like that post. So this is basically something about the social media blog or posting issue. And linkage is the website address that you can click on to get in, to enter in that, on that website. Okay, ladies, now I would like you to focus on this little piece of article on part two. Please read about Angel Evans and why is his blog called Digital Nomad. After reading, please discuss with your partners.
Problems with this, with this word.
Yeah, I know that.
I have problems.
Oh, yeah.
I thought that this was website. Website is more general?
Yes, exactly. Websites includes everything, but homepage refers to the very representative of the blog.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Okay, ladies, could you please tell me why is his black card? Did you tell them? Because he travels all the time and he's always online. Perfect. And I just heard that Ingrid brought up the vocabularies and said they are exactly what you have difficulties in. Okay, perfect. So now, ladies, I want you to pay attention to these highlighted vocabularies. And what is a blogger? Can anybody tell me? A blogger. Yeah, a person who writes the blog, who writes the article, or who writes something online. The person is called a blogger. And website, Mina, do you have any idea on the website? What's the meaning of website?
Website on the internet. I can't explain, sorry.
It's okay. When we want to enter a specific web page, we have to enter something, right? We have to type some letters or numbers.
Normally it starts with www.
Yeah.
Right?
So it's a long address for you to get into a specific web page. It's called the website. And do you know what's the meaning of online, Nicole?
A person is something.
The internet. Yeah, he's connected.
Okay.
Yeah, he has or Wi-Fi or other channels to be connected with other people through the internet. We describe the status or situation as being online. And blogs, we all know that as then that you can read or write on the internet and you can share with other people. And posts. Julie?
Announced something, you posted.
Yeah, it's the articles in the blog. And so what's the relationship between blog and our post? Can anybody tell me? Grace, do you have any ideas? What's the relationship between blogs and articles? Oh, posts. Something in posts, and the posts are in someone's blog, right?
So blog means the writing something on the online blog.
Yeah, it's generally describing writing something online, blogging, when it is a verb, but when it is a noun, it describes. I don't know how to. Maybe you can think of it as a place. As your personal or public place on internet that you can share anything.
So someone writing us something and then that is a blogger, right?
The person is a blogger.
Yeah, blogger.
Yeah.
Let's
perfect.
Think of this way. So blog refers to the website that bloggers would write something on it. And for post, we can use in two ways. The first way
is to use it as a noun. When the post is a noun, it means the articles the bloggers write. When we use post as a verb, it means the action that the blogger would put the article into their blogs.
Oh, so now when you use the verb and the posted something, right?
Yes, so blogger posts on their blogs. They can be really, really complicated, but it is easy too.
So this page is 64, right? Because of the when
And what's the meaning of upload? Upload, download.
Oh, that is I know, I think. Downloading. You need something to do and then go download. Upload it. When you picture upload.
Upload means you send something to the internet or to the website, and download means you get something, you obtain something from the internet. For instance, if you are finding a job and you are filling the information, the forms on the website, and the company asks you to upload your profile pictures or your personal statement or your cover letter, so you have to upload your cover letter or pictures from your computer and then send it to the web page. And download means you want some music or movies and you download from the website, from the websites to your own computer. So that is that's the same thing, but in different, totally opposite directions.
So the, I want to confirm, the uploaded is something from the other internet, like example, pictures?
No, upload actually express the meaning that you are sending something to the internet.
Oh.
And download is exactly the meaning that you just talked about, as getting something from the internet.
Other people's internet also, not only mine.
Yeah, of course. Download means getting something from other websites. And upload means you send something or you put some resources on the internet. So ladies, do you know what's the meaning of comment or comment?
When you have some opinion, you can comment.
Perfect. Perfect. And you can use it as both verb and a noun. As a noun, it is pronounced as comment. And when it is used as a verb, it is pronounced as comment. The stress is different. And homepage is the main website for a specific person or an organization or a company. So ladies, now I would like you to match the highlighted words in exercise 2 with the definitions. And then you can discuss with your partners about the definitions that you have matched.
So people can ask, what is your homepage? You can ask the, your homepage.
As long as you are a blogger, yes, you can. But for me, because I don't blog, if you ask me what is my homepage, I would say I have a homepage.
At the time, I don't have an answer to you only.
destination, you can describe it as the place or the aim that you want to go. Destination, you can, is a place or the aim or the purpose. It means somewhere or something or some places that you want to go. For instance, I want to go to the Times Square. So the Times Square is the destination for my trip. Yeah. So you want to go to Europe for traveling, and Europe is your destination. Yeah. In the airports, that you can see that the flight is from somewhere to somewhere, and the to is the destination. Yeah, the place that you would like to go. Yeah.
But if comma follows closely by a subject,
so
let's say this
website
comments on something, then comment is a verb. For example, what is comment in your
sentence? It's a blogger.
Yeah.
On your blog?
No,
blogger.
Blogger. Yes.
But I don't think I use.
Yes, exactly. So
do you think
now we know comment is also a count
verb.
And it's singular we would plus to refer it as only one comment. And you go to the Google, there is like the logo, and then where you do the research, and that is the homepage.
Really?
But after you look for something in the website, it will direct you to another page,
and
it will not be the homepage, but only the website.
Still a little bit confused. over the idea of what is a website and what is a homepage.
Yeah, that
needs more explain. Yes, so can I have everyone's attention here? When we are talking about a website, everything can be a website as long as we enter the address at here, okay? Let's say I want to go to google.com. Here, this page we are looking at is the homepage of Google. We have the local, we have the place we can do searching. Other than that, we don't have any other information. This is the representative page of Google. So we call this the homepage of Google. Now if I search English, it does not look like the homepage we were on, but I can find more information. It is still a white page, a website, but it is not the homepage of Google. Okay? So normally if we enter something, let's say YouTube, this page we are entering is the home page of YouTube. We can see there is a home button here, and whenever we click on home, it will lead us back to the home page. But we can also go to other sections of the website. Let's say music, sports, but is it a homepage? No. Here is the homepage.
You can understand it as a main website.
So homepage means like someone, the individual, the address, right? Like someone have a house, she has own house and the address, like the same thing as a, like a home page.
You can understand it as a living room.
Yes. You would first introduce your guests into the living room.
Yeah.
And if they want, you can let them to visit your bedroom, your studies, but they will always go back to the living room. So living room is the home page of all websites. Is it clear now?
Yeah.
Okay, now ladies, I want you to take out your test paper. Yeah, your test paper, and please look at part 8. Part 8. Yeah, now I want everybody to redo the exercises on part 8. I'm sure that you will have the right answers.
This means the whole room.
I didn't correct you the right answers. Yeah. If I put a line on
which one is the one? Right. You send the
that all of you can have the right answer now.
Try to search for some blogs and play around on the internet, then I guess you will find something more useful.
This is a really big mistake. Never new Ferrari. So ladies, Kelly is a what? I mean, an archaeologist. What? He's a blogger. Kelly's a person, right? He's a blogger on an archaeologist what?
Website.
Website? She travels to different cities. Every day she... Kate is a blogger on the archaeologist website. Mm-hmm. She travels to different cities. Every day she what about her work? She blogs about her work. She writes what from different countries? Perfect. Writes posts. And she's often what at night?
And when she's open?
She's often online at night. And she uploads photographs of fantastic places. Readers have left Kelly lots of comments. The first one or the second one? Comments or the comments? Perfect. Comments, because it is a noun. And it is used as a noun. And her what is? Homepage. Perfect. Okay, now ladies, I'm sure that you have a very clear idea about what's the meaning of all of those online vocabulary, and I hope that you can use them on your daily life, a certain internet experience to describe to other people what are you going to do or what you are doing using those verbs and